The ACT party leader is adamant one of his senior MPs no longer believes that climate change is a hoax or that people who think the planet is warming are nut jobs. David Seymour insists Mark Cameron doesn't believe many of the things he used to regularly tweet about shortly before entering Parliament. Senior political reporter Benedict Collins has more.
He's one of the ACT party's top MPs, a dairy farmer turned politician.
David said to me quite candidly, "You're the guy, you're the authentic voice."
But it's Mark Cameron's controversial takes on Twitter shortly before he joined ACT, like that climate change is a farce, that David Seymour doesn't want to hear about.
He doesn't believe that. I think trying to drag that up now is really just B-grade journalism.
I mean, you're saying this is B-grade journalism, but I mean, there's a very real chance that Mark Cameron's going to be a minister in about 60 days' time, right? There is that chance, and people, you know, if he believes that climate change is a hoax, okay,
which he doesn't, so.
No, I'm not a climate change denier.
Do you think the public will believe it, given you were so adamant in 2019 that global warming was a farce?
People have potentially questioned whether I thought climate change was real or not. I maintain it is. It's again, and I stress the point, I represent the interests of rural New Zealand.
And that's a real worry from my perspective because it's rural communities that are hit the hardest by climate change.
Mark Cameron also tweeted about political leaders being part of a globalist conspiracy. That term's linked to anti-Jewish commentary.
So what does he mean when he uses the word globalist?
I'm not sure what he meant.
I don't know what was going in my mind 5 years ago any more than, gracious me, what was happening the year before last.
Why were you using the word globalist?
I made stupid remarks as an individual that I don't believe to be true.
Well, does that concern you?
Yeah, but I also think we're starting to see why Chris Luxon's not ruling out Winston Peters right now. He's looking at what some people are saying in the ACT party and what they stand for.
Mark Cameron has previously apologised for his tweets targeting MPs. He described Jacinda Ardern as being an IQ lightweight and Julianne Jenter as dumb, and implied Goldie's Gutterman was too.
I apologised then and I'll apologise again.
To be online abusing elected representatives in that particular really gross way, I think it takes a bit more than an apology.
Apology or not, questions remain about what Mark Cameron really believes. Benedict Collins, One News.